Welcome to Queen's Public Library. This is Leah, Children's Librarian at Hillcrest, and today I'm going to be showing you how to do a remote printing request, which is a new service that the library is offering. So to get to this page, there is a link in the description below the video, but you can also type into your browser queenslib.org/QPLprint, and that should bring you to this page. If you are already logged in, this is what you're going to see. I'm already logged in. If you're not logged in, then they're going to ask you to log in with your library card number and your PIN number, and then you should be able to start the process. So the steps to upload the document are that first you choose a location that you're going to be picking up your document from, and then you're going to be redirected to OneDrive where you upload your file, and then you're going to put in your library card number and your last name. And then once it's uploaded, you're going to be contacted by a staff member when it's ready to be picked up. It should be in 2 days, within 2 days, usually even shorter than that. And make sure to bring an ID with you when you're going to pick up your print job. A few things to keep in mind. You're going to be limited to 20 pages per day, same as we always do. And you're only going to be able to print in black and white on standard letter-sized paper. If you need more than one copy of a document, the same document, then you could just call the library to clarify exactly what you need. So we're going to start off with selecting the location. I'm going to select Hillcrest because that's my branch, but you could, any of the bolded branches here are the ones that are open for to-go service. And once you've selected a branch, then you can click where it says, click here to upload your document. So I'm going to click there and I'm going to be redirected to the OneDrive site. All right, now I've landed on the Microsoft OneDrive page for the Hillcrest printing. So here's where you would upload your file. So make sure that your file is saved on your device. So whether that's a phone, a tablet, a laptop, a desktop, it needs to be saved on the device itself within the file system so that you can browse for it, as opposed to, let's say, if you have like a Google Doc or something that's in your email, then those you need to download first onto your device. And then you would be able to upload them onto this OneDrive service. So also keep in mind that it's got to be a file that we're able to print. So a PDF or a Word document is ideal for this. Other like uncommon versions of files are going to give us difficulty with the printing. So we probably won't be able to print it for you. So you're going to click on select files and then browse through your folders to find the right one. All right, I have uploaded my test file. And this is a Word document, so it should pose no issues. If I have more files to add, I would click on Add More Files, and I would add a few more. And if I needed to, let's say, get this file printed several times, if I wanted like 5 copies of this one-page document, then maybe I would just call the library to clarify what I was looking for in that regard. And once I have this uploaded, then I'm going to put in my first name and my last name. But remember, we said that in the first name field, we're going to put in your library card number. So that usually starts with a 111844 or something like that. And then it's got like a whole string of numbers here. So put in your library card number over there in the first name field, and then put in your last name in the last name field. So I'm just going to create a customer last name. And then I can click on upload, and the library should contact you first by phone if you've got a phone number in your account. And if they don't have any success with that, then they're going to try to email you. But it should be ready within 2 days. As always, we're happy to help. Give the library a call if you have any issues. And we hope that you enjoy this service.